The HCS finals for Halo 5 have been completed over the weekend, and we have a brand new champion. This weekend also marks the end of Halo 5 competitive, so what does this mean moving forward? As well as the best pros voted on by other pros, so these guys are clearly the best players in the game. With an HCS recap as well for the weekend, and let's get right into the video here. How's it going, everybody? It's Kevin here once again, giving you another gameplay commentary. Today we're talking about the HCS finals that just happened. Final Halo 5 event for this fantastic game, to be honest. And it's a bit sad, but you know, maybe it's just, you know, the time has come pretty much. And so in this video, we're going to do a little recap of everything. So if you guys like these information videos, please make sure to tap that like button. Let me know you want to see some more content like this. Leave a comment down below what your thoughts were on the HCS event for this weekend, because we have Halo 5 and Halo 3 were both played this weekend. So let me know what you think about that. And if you're new to the channel, want to stay up to date with anything related to the channel, make sure to tap subscribe, as we upload a lot of Halo content. So you got that to look forward to as well. So let's get right into the video here. Like we said in the beginning of this video, this was the last Halo 5 event, sadly. I guess maybe just because the viewership just wasn't quite there to really maintain the production value of these streams moving forward. But this also does not mean it's going to be the end of Halo competitive as we move forward in with along with this video here. But going into the event, my favorite team was definitely Reciprocity. You know, they had a really good showing in the 2Ks like they normally have, but I think that this one they really could have had an opportunity, and they really did. So we're gonna go with the top eight teams that finished out right here. So we had Elevate and Mentality tied for seventh. We had Accelerate and Anaheim Pirates, which Anaheim Pirates are from PBL, that Pro Battle League, which is kind of cool to see them kind of get, you know, do very well in competitive Halo. Fourth, we had Splice, the champs that have been around for so long. They've been so dominant. I think maybe like all that COD playing caught up to them, because they finished fourth because Renegades beat them out for third place. They had Reciprocity finish second, and TOX are the champions for the final Halo 5 event. If you guys didn't watch the streams, oh, you missed out, because it was a crazy good showing for at least for numbers, at least for people watching these streams, and the games were fantastic as well. The first match for the winners finals between Reciprocity and TOX was fantastic. Went down to game 7. TOX brought it back from a 3-0 to bring it back 3-3 to try to get the win. They couldn't quite pull out the finish game. But for the grand finals, TOX had to win not one, but two best of seven series to get the championship. And they did just so, but not just winning. They did it in dominant fashion of finishing the last two series 8-0. They swept them. They swept Reciprocity two times in a row, which is just insane. I had high hopes for Reciprocity. I thought after beating TOX in the winners final, I'm like, oh, they got this. They're on the way. They're going to win. Splice has been knocked down to fourth by Renegades. And I think, you know, from what, you know, I saw from Reciprocity against from TOX, I thought like, oh, they got this, no problem. But the grand finals, Reciprocity did this, the winning final, winners finals Reciprocity team didn't quite show up for the grand finals, because it was a, they just got completely swept. And I could just tell that after the first like two or three, after game two, that TOX was in Reciprocity's head. TOX was just not able, Reciprocity was just not able to capitalize on as many opportunities as TOX was. Clearly TOX was the better team. A lot of people are saying that TOX is probably one of the greatest Halo teams of all time. I would have to agree with that, since TOX has been in the finals for every single Halo 5 event. And back, even back when they were Optic as well. And even those teams back in the MCC, these guys were Optic, were, you know, one of the best teams as well. And so this is quite possibly one of the greatest teams of all time playing Halo 5. And talking about greatest teams, and you know, they were probably made of great players, which is rightfully so. And a cool thing happened is that a lot of the pros voted on each other about who is the best in certain aspects of the game. And so we have like an MVP, we have best sniper, best pistol shot. So let's get right into the best of players when it comes to HCS. So for best pistol shot went to Royal 2, and he definitely was on display for this recent HCS event, and rightfully so. Royal 2 plays a much more of an anchoring role, where he kind of helps control spawns and make sure that, you know, he has, most of his shots are going to be at the very long range, mid to long range shots, and he's very accurate with it. And Royal 2 is one of the best like anchoring solid players in the game. And a guy with that kind of position needs to have a solid pistol shot, and he certainly does. Well-deserved rank on that one. The next one, we had best movement in Halo 5, and clearly that one went to Shotzzy. Shotzzy is like revolutionized Halo 5 gameplay, and you know, and now everyone's spring jumping and finding these crazy new locations. There's so many times you watch Shotzzy playing, like, I didn't know you can do that. It's because he just jumps into like custom games and just jumps around by himself and just to figure out new ways to move around the map. And movement is so important in Halo 5 that definitely best movement would have to go to Shotzzy. Best Halo 5 sniper, Frosty. That has to be absolutely true, because Frosty went absolutely off in these HCS finals, showcasing his sniper skill quite often. And some of the shots he was just pulling off, I'm like, there's no way I will ever have enough time to put that much practice in to get these kind of shots that he's pulling off. Absolutely insane and very well deserved. And they also had voted on best Halo 5 series, which they said it was back in 2006 between Renegades and Team Alliance. I still need to go back and watch this, but I guarantee you, if the pros said this is the best one, you know it's going to be good. They also voted on the best player award, the MVP of Halo 5, the entire series. Who won it? Well, it was Frosty. And after watching this event, I would have to absolutely agree with that. Every single game, Frosty does well. He doesn't miss. He doesn't mess up. Frosty is Frosty. He is like one of the greatest Halo players of all time. And for him to win, you know, great best player of Halo 5, 100% correct on that one. A lot of people probably say Shotzzy as well. Shotzzy's fantastic as well. But Splice finished fourth in this one. So, and then you have, you know, obviously the wins matter. And, you know, TOX won, best player goes to Frosty. 100% agree with that. But there was also this weekend, there was a Halo 3 2v2 showdown tournament. And yeah, it was actually getting some rather good viewership, around like 10K viewers I saw on Twitch watching Halo 3 competitive 2v2 as well. That's pretty good for right now, where Halo is right now in like the sphere of gaming, to be able to get, you know, couple tens of thousands of people watching. That's pretty damn good, in my opinion. I sadly didn't get a chance to watch it because I can't spend my whole day watching Halo. I'd love to do that. I was busy with like work, and I actually did a stream as well. So, but you know, this it was a really good showing for Halo 3 competitive, and they're actually going to be moving forward with some more Halo 3 competitive, some 4v4 tournaments coming up. I mentioned in the grassroots video I uploaded previously. Check that out. Link checked out at the end of this video. And well, so the winners for the Halo 3 tournament were GMS. They beat out Optic Gaming, which was Flame Sword. Which was Flame Sword and Roy. Two very solid players and very notable players in the Halo community. And you know, they pushed it pretty far, but GMS came up on top on that one. Really looking forward to seeing some Halo 3 4v4 competitive gameplay coming in January and March. So look forward to that one as well. So overall, what are my thoughts on the whole experience of Halo 5 competitive? Well, looking back, it had a bit of a bumpy road. I feel like I could tell that 343 really wanted to try to craft this synergy between your standard Halo and the competitive Halo. And that basically, you're playing the exact same game, and the only difference is just your teamwork and your playing ability. So like, give players that opportunity of like making that gameplay connection between how I play the game and what they're doing. They're like, oh, they're just really good at the game, I can get good at the game. Try and create that connection. I can see what they were trying to do, but I just don't think it really played out exactly in their favor. I mean, starting out with autos and, you know, the motion sensor on competitive Halo. And so, and through various iterations of the competitive, I think the last year of Halo 5 competitive was probably some of the best competitive Halo gameplay I've ever played, at least, and probably some of the best I've ever seen, and probably definitely some of the most entertaining. And so, though it kind of started out a bit rough, but basically throughout the 3 years of it being around, it really grew into something special, and I'm honestly kind of sad to see it go. I feel like we finally kind of peaked in the gameplay quality for HCS gameplay, and sadly enough, we only had like a full year worth of gameplay tournaments for that. But I think at least we got to a good point, though. That's the main thing. And Yeah, the viewership may have been kind of declining over each one, but yeah, that's just what's going to happen when your game's 3 years old and didn't have the greatest of launches. It should be interesting also to see how these 3v or these 4v4 or 2v2 Halo 3 tournaments go. Maybe that might spark a little bit more interest back into competitive Halo. I mean, everyone loves Halo 3. I mean, come on, literally everyone likes Halo 3. So if you guys enjoyed this video, please make sure to tap that like button. Let me know if you want to see some more content like this. Let me comment down below what you guys' thoughts are on Halo 5 competitive as a whole for the last 3 years. Personally, I think it kind of started out pretty low, got to a really good point, and kind of left out with a bit of a bang, I'd say. It was pretty good. And if you're new to the channel, stay up to date with anything Halo related, make sure to tap subscribe on the channel as it keeps you up to date with anything Halo related. Make sure to check out the videos on the screen right now if you missed any content from me. I'll catch you all in the next video. Peace out.